how we do it. And left foot. Y'all know how we do it.
You cha-cha with to right. You cha-cha to left. You turn to right. And move to the left.
I see ya.
You turn to the right.
Here we go, y'all.
To left.
Back
it up. Hold it down, hold it down. Hold it down. Hold it, hold it, hold it now.
We're on. We're here at the Dodge Pavilion at the 2007 Los Angeles Auto Show, and I'm here with Mr. Scott Brown. Scott, would you state your name and spell it, please?
Scott Brown, S-C-O-T-T-B-R-O-W-N. Nice and simple.
And you're with PR for Chrysler Corporation, LLC.
That's correct.
And what are we looking at behind us here? This looks like a very special version of a Viper.
Yeah, this is the 2008 Viper ACR, SRT 10 ACR.
What's the ACR stand for?
American Club Racer.
Now, why would you name a car after the American Club Racer Club?
We basically have a real high percentage of our Viper owners amateur race.
I'm Kay Tolliver with Schultz here at the Jazz Fest West, who performed a little bit earlier today. Thank you for taking the time to interview with us.
My pleasure.
Tell us a little bit about, you are with Down to the Bone currently, and then you're also on your own. Tell me why you chose to do your own little solo project, or not little, your own solo project, and how that's worked out.
Yeah, it's an enormous solo project, but I've been with Down to the Bone now, we're in our 10th year, it's our 10th anniversary year, and it just felt like, after all this time that I've been doing this, it just felt like a logical step for me to do, now that I'm now living in Los Angeles, so... With the move, 3 years we've been here now and all that, it was just like time to sort of like step out and do a solo thing. So that was where we're up to about now.
It's 2005 and we still have soldiers over there dying. There are innocent people over there dying. Innocent people there that are just on the street dying for no particular cause because this man feels that he runs America. Why is it that every single time Bush comes up for an election, something happens down in Florida? How come something always happens in Florida whenever Bush comes up for an election?
War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go!
War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go! War criminal Bush must go!
I really love him, his administration. I support his policy, his foreign policy, and there's children going to school in my country, and I really support him, and freedom and democracy, it's the goal of the administration. We're spreading it all over the world, and it's.
How long have you been in this country?
15 years, most of my life, and I love this country. I'm proud of my heritage. Yeah. I love Bush.
As far as the weapons of mass destruction, there were weapons of mass destruction. Every single country in the UN voted on the fact that this man, Saddam Hussein, did not honor his resolutions. 14 of them continually. He actually killed 6 million of his own people with mustard gas. That is a weapon of mass destruction. That all of the UN countries agree that there was a problem and this man was a global threat. President Bush was the only one that stood up and said, we need to take care of it. We need to do something about it. And the fact that they didn't find stockpiles is irrelevant.
Let it go!
I'm sorry, but I think it's
Let it go!
Fuck
the
police!
Let it go!
Fuck
the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it go!
Fuck the police!
Let it
nothing by being brute force. There's always bigger people and smaller people.
Yeah,
don't go that way.
And go on your own side.
There is no side in the United States.
It's all the country. Now all loud on this
because you're rats.
You called us over here.
What the fuck
you did you calling us over here? You can talk shit. Threatening to fucking kill me? That's peace. That's peace.
Fest 2005 has just been an awesome thing. So many people have worked so diligently to bring this to pass, but none have worked as hard as this man. This is Elder Reyes. He's over our evangelism team. He is the maestro behind the Blessed Fest. I just want him to share with you for a few moments what he has in his heart.
Man, it's truly been a blessing with the Blessed Fest.
Yes.
The primary focus was
souls for Jesus Christ, amen. And it was just a blessing to work and see all this come together, people being delivered, healed, saved, amen. That's what it's all about, amen. Like Pastor said, there's no money, amen, can outmatch a soul, amen. So yes, that's what it's all about, amen. I encourage you, amen, to continue to serve Christ and do these kind of things, amen, to reach out into the community so souls can be saved for Jesus Christ, amen. God bless you.
I'm Pastor Kevin T. Borland of the Worship with Truth Church of God in Christ in the beautiful city of Rancho Cucamonga. 2005 was live, but 2006, you want to be there in the mix.